So if you subscribe to the Elementor mailing list, you may know that you've just had an email saying that the beta version 2.4 is available for testing. In this video, I want to show you some of the new features that have been added in and how I think these really are a game changer when you're creating websites. So if you're wondering why I have this screen open in front of me, it's because it demonstrates some of the new features that we have inside this beta version. Now, my name is Paul C, and this is WPTuts, the channel where we create beautiful WordPress websites together. If this is your first time on the channel, please consider subscribing and smashing that bell icon below to become part of the WP crew and be notified every time new content is added. Okay, so let's just jump over to the dashboard, and as you can see, I've got the page that I've created in front of me. Now, one of the things I want to show you is how we have a lot more control now over background images and also some of the cool things we can do with those background images. So let's just start off with a fresh page, and let me show you how I built this to demonstrate some of the cool things we now have in this forthcoming version of Elementor. Now, when working with background images in Elementor, you'll know you don't have the best level of control. However, a lot of that has been addressed in this beta version. So let's take a look at some of those things. First thing we're going to do is just create a single one row, one column block. So we've got some area to put an image into. We'll set this height to be fit to screen, so we make sure we maximize it to the entire screen resolution. What we'll do then is we'll jump over the style section, come to our background option, and you can see everything looks exactly the same as it always has. Let's come in and choose the classic option. You should notice now that we get the option to choose the image, but we also get a new option that allows us to choose a different image based upon the device we're viewing the website on. So let's take a look at that in action. Let's click and we'll add this image in for the city. We'll insert that media. You can see now that's inserted the image in exactly the same way as you'd expect. However, if I change this over and say on a tablet view, I can click on there, you can see it currently shows us the scaled down version of the image that we've just selected, but we can come in and choose a completely different image. So let's just choose this one, and you can see now when we're looking at this on a tablet, we'll see it with this particular image in the background. However, we switch over to the desktop and we get the different image. So this is great if you want to optimize your images for the device that your website is being viewed upon. So someone viewing it on a mobile device could have a lower resolution version or a different image, whereas someone with a faster internet connection on a desktop could have the full high-res version. So that's really cool to start seeing that. We also, though, have some additional options. So if we look underneath where we have the position attachment and so on, we have those same options to fine-tune and tweak the device that we're using. So you can see we can have a different position for different devices. So let's come in and say we want this to be bottom center. So we focus on the main part of this particular image. Attachment we'll leave as is. Repeat we'll disable that, so we'll say we don't want any repeat. And the size, you can see we've now got auto, cover, contain, and custom. Let's just say we want this to cover, so we can make sure that it covers the screen size no matter what size it actually is. But then we could also come in and say, well, on a mobile device or a tablet, we want this image to be positioned differently. So this works whether we're using a different image or if we're using the same image, we might want the focus to be different because the screen sort of size and shape is going to be different to your traditional desktop. Hope that makes sense. So let's just say with this one, we want this to be positioned differently. We'll say we want this to be top center. So we can kind of focus on the person's head as opposed to focusing maybe on the middle of their body and then on a different device size, we kind of lose the focus of the image. And again, we can adjust the attachment option, the repeat, and the size. So there's some really great options available there for us just by using these new tools that we've got for the background image. Now for me, I think this is a bit of a game changer because you do work with a lot of images in the background. This gives you so much more granular control to make sure it looks fantastic on whatever device it's being viewed upon. Now there are a couple of things I would still love to see. This is part of Elementor itself and not just limited to this particular set of options. We are really limited to only viewing a phone in portrait view and a tablet in portrait view. We really need to open up some additional options for seeing things in landscape mode as well, so we can fine tune and tweak. I'd love to see that built directly into the interface or something that we could enable. Now, before we move on to the next thing that I want to demonstrate, there's one thing that I just want to jump back to show you that is also new. If we come back over to the style tab to the background, you can see we've got the cover option, and we always had default auto cover and contain. We now have the option for custom. And we click to enable that, you can see we can now adjust this based upon the slider, and we can work on pixel, percentage, ems, all different kinds of measurements, so we can set this up to make sure that the width of this is perfect, again, based upon the device that we want to use it on. So we have a lot of control over that entire background image. So not only do we have control over the different background images and the different devices they're viewed upon, we can do the same thing with the border options. If we jump to the border section, you can see we now have the option to choose different border widths based upon the device. So at the moment, we set this to 50 pixels. However, if I jump over to a tablet view, you can see it still retains the 50 pixels, which might not be ideal for the view that we're working with. So what I can do is I can easily come in and I can adjust this based upon the value I want to place in there. So let's just say I want to set 30 on there. And if we jump over onto a mobile view, you can see we're currently viewing 30 on there, and we could say, well, let's have this set to 15, and we can obviously do the same things we normally would, which is adjust things like the styling of the text and so on. So we can adjust that based upon being on a mobile device, and obviously we can do things like adjust the paddings and margins and things along those lines. So again, it's quite cool now that we have the option to go in and adjust those items. We're not restricted to just the width of the actual outline border. We can also come in and control the curvature of it. So if we want to, we can adjust the border radius based upon the device it's being viewed upon. So it just gives us a lot more control now over how everything is displayed upon different types of devices. So jumping back over to the dashboard, if we take a look on the left-hand side, you can see we've still got the Elementor menu entry. Now, some of the options in there have changed a little bit. We also have the templates option. So they've moved the templates out of the Elementor menu and gave it its own section inside the dashboard. Reason being is we've got some more control available to us with the templates. You can see we've got save templates, which is where we go and see any of the templates we've got, or we can create a new one directly from inside there. So we just jump into that. You'll see that's the typical look that we've kind of become used to inside Elementor and Elementor Pro, which has more options. However, we've got the add new. We also have categories. Now, categories is a great way of grouping the various different templates together to make it more logical for you, the end user. So when you are working on this, and you might be working on lots and lots of different templates, these sections at the top where you've got pages and sections and global widgets and so on, it can get a little unwieldy very quickly. So the advent of adding in categories makes life a lot easier. So you can see whenever you have a template listed, you now have the categories column. As you can see, I've already created one called blog templates. So if I click on that, that'll now filter through all of the templates and find anything that I've categorized under the blog templates section. So you can use this as another level of organizing the actual template structures with Elementor Pro. It's very easy to work with. If we jump over to the categories section, click on there, you can see it works in very much the same way as categories inside posts and tags and so on and things like that. You simply add in a new field entry. So we'll just call this one, we'll call this page templates. And we'll just simply add new. And as you can see, we can control the hierarchy of this. So if we want to get even more low-level control, we can start parenting things together and so on. I'll keep this really simple. We'll just create a new category. I'll say add new category, and you can see now that adds it in on the right-hand side. We've got the count of any kind of templates that fit into that particular category we created. And what we can do then is we can just simply jump over to our templates. We could either add a new one in and then sort of apply a category to it, or we can retrospectively go back to a page or template we created before, and we can just simply jump into that. You can see on the right hand side we now have categories inside there, which I can say this is a page template. Hit update, we'll jump back out then to our saved templates, and you can see now the header new is set as a page template category. If I click on there, it'll now subfilter that information out to just show the templates that are inside that particular category. So those are the two key things that I wanted to highlight in this video. There are lots more updates in this beta version, but I don't really want to cover those. I don't think they're necessary for most of us users. These are the things that I think are going to be most useful when it's released in version 2.4, hopefully very soon. Now, as always, I'd love to get your feedback on what you think of these new features that are forthcoming. Do you think they're cool? Do you think there's something you could use? Are there features that you think really need to be added into future versions of Elementor? Please let me know in the comment section below, where we can discuss this thing in a little bit more detail. As always, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down, but let me know in the comment section why you didn't enjoy the video. It helps me create better content for you moving forward. Well, my name's been Paul C. This has been WPTuts, and until next time, take care.